Sally Sisbella.
Zayna Motley.
Mike Harry.
Seth Wallace.
And this is our response point. Our survey questions are, have you ever been in a natural disaster? What type of disaster did you experience? How did the experience turn out? Was it your first encounter with a severe weather storm? When and where were you when the disaster happened? What did you learn from your experience? What was the experience like after the disaster? What steps did you take to protect yourself? What did you do to prepare for the disaster, and how did you feel after the disaster?
What do you need for an emergency? You need water, food, radio, flashlight, first aid kit, personal sanitation, a whistle, and a container.
What to do if a natural disaster occurs?
Find safe places in each room. Make sure all family members know how to respond to an earthquake. Ask an out-state relative or friend to serve as the family contact. And during the disaster, if indoors, take cover under a piece of heavy furniture or against an inside wall and stay inside. After the disaster, be prepared for aftershocks, help injured or track people, and give first aid when appropriate.
Before a tornado, conduct tornado drills into each season. Designate an area in the home as a shelter. Know the difference between tornado watches and warnings. During a tornado, if at home, go to the storm cellar or lowest part of a building. If there is no basement, go to an inner hallway or room without any windows. After the tornado, help injured or trapped people. Give first aid where appropriate, and don't try to move the injured people unless they are in danger of further injury. If you're in a car, never try to outdrive the tornado. Get out of the car and try to find shelter and learn danger signs. Wildfires. Before the disaster, learn and teach safe fire practices. Build away from nearby trees or bushes. Always have a way to extinguish a fire. Never leave a fire unattended. During the disaster, if trapped in a wildfire, you cannot outrun it.
Place valuables that will not be damaged by water in a pool or by a pond. After the disaster, be cautious when re-entering a burning wild area. Hot spots can flare up without warning. Supplies you will need to have on hand: flashlight, extra batteries, portable radios, first aid kits, emergency food and water, non-electric can openers, medicine, cash, and credit cards.
For disaster or flood, on the warning signs, community alert systems. Check valves for sewer traps to prevent flood water from backing up in the sewer drain. Plan and practice an evacuation route for each use case. Have disaster supplies on hand. Develop the risk communication plan in case of separation. Ask your insurance agents about flood insurance. And then during disaster, tell them the battery operator radio to get the latest emergency information. Outdoors, climb the high ground and stay there. Avoid biking, walking through any flood waters. In a car, turn around and move in the way of the car stalls. Abandon and climb the higher ground. If advised to evacuate yourself immediately to avoid flooding risks, be sure to follow the recommended evacuation routes and listen to the radio for evacuation instructions. After disaster, don't return phone if the authorities express the state of safe to do so. After damage, you may need assistance, inspect foundation cracks, or other damage for any set of walls, floors, doors, and windows. Just make sure the building is not in danger of collapsing. Watch out for animals, especially poisonous snakes, that may have come into your home with the flood waters. Watch for loose platter and things that can fall. Throw away all food that has come in contact with the flood waters.
People to contact. the American Red Cross, Southwestern Electric Power Company, and the water company.
And pet shelters, animal shelters, volunteer of Texas, and Tyler Animal Control. Thank you.
Did you come up with your 10 questions yourself?
Yes.
You have done those?